up in the morning, first thing, gotta taste it. Drunk out my mind on an everyday basis. Stay throwing up Andre by the cases. Smoking mad blood, so much money that I wasted. Going through the stages, growing up young black male trying to make it. Caught up in the matrix, wasn't lack of discipline or deep self-hatred. Supposed it could have been a form of self-medication. Stress on my mind, it was a way to escape it. Wash away the problems when I didn't want to face it. I told myself it was just recreation. I could stop anytime, G, it's not like a basin. But deep inside, I felt my health deteriorate. Gout in my leg, toothache so irritating. Wasting mad time, could have been paper chasing. Slipping on my pimpin', catching all kind of cases. Learning the hard way, first-hand education. Had to give my body a break and make some changes. Had to get back on solid foundation. Tighten up my diet, workouts, and meditation.
That's right.
Don't happen in a day, it take patience. Still every day it's a challenge, but I'ma make it. A soldier don't work on the struggle, we embrace it. Don't worry what another nigga think, that's liberation.
Hey, good afternoon. We are here in the backstage of the Ashkenaz in Berkeley, California with Stic.man from Dead Prez. How are you?
I'm super duper, how you doing?
Great. You had an amazing show, and I wanted to congratulate you for all your hard work, you know, over the past few years, you know, actually more than a decade, and I wanted you to talk a little bit about the latest album.
Yeah. Well, we got a Dead Prez album that's free on deadprez.com called Revolutionary But Gangsta Grills that we did with DJ Drama, and I just put out a solo record called A Workout. About health and fitness for boxing, yoga, martial arts, you know, running, you know, things like that I'm inspired by. I've been sober for 2 years, no weed, no alcohol, you know, I'm on my vegetarianism, so it's just something I'm celebrating that right now, you know, so yeah.
One of the things that I find the most impressive was that I was reading your a little bit about your biography and your background, and how I see a lot of people in the movement speak a lot, but in their personal life it's a different story, and for me it's very admirable to see everything that you're doing, and also to know that you've been in your relationship with your wife for over 18 years and that you wrote a book with her called Revolutionary Love. What was that about?
We're writing it now, and okay. Probably about a few more months and we'll be done. It's about healthy relationships and things that work for us, you know what I mean, and just sharing our story, you know, things we learn, and, you know, insights from learning how to coexist, you know what I mean, and still being happy 18 years later, you know what I mean? So, yeah.
A long road, huh?
Yeah. When I was 19, she was 18, we met, you know what I mean? And now I'm 21. So, it's been 18, so, you know what I mean? It's been a blessing, though, you know what I mean? And she's a holistic health counselor, my wife. Afia is her name. She's a writer and, you know, martial artist and, you know, great mom, all that. Yeah.
So for Dead Prez, I was reading that there was an album coming out in 2011 called The Information of Age.
The Information Age album. Yeah, we're in the process. We actually working with Steve Marley and some of his brothers, and they're executive producing our new Dead Prez album. So the title may be Information Age, it might not, you know what I mean? But, you know, we're working on it. We got to get the music right, and then we'll let it loose.
Does that have to do with anything with WikiLeaks and everything that's going on in the world?
Oh, yeah, it's definitely current events, you know what I mean? It's definitely. But working with Steve allows us to have so much more musicality, you know, to the words, you know what I mean? And it's a good change for us to stay stimulated by different music. Like with the Workout album was a great change for me. New subject matter, not, you know, like you were saying, always saying the same thing, the political rhetoric, when we want to see the action, you know, we want to see activism in action, you know what I mean? So, you know, what better way than to be active? You know, a lot of times we talk about the corporations and things, but then we consuming the poison and everything that they're making, you know, making a killing off, you know, really. So I think simple things every day is the best way to make an impact, you know what I mean, and build a momentum from there, you know. So our album Information Age is about the simple things, you know what I mean? So
well, I want to thank you so much. I think it's really funny when people label you guys as confrontational when in reality, you know, you're speaking about social justice, education, access to healthcare, you know, and just basic human rights. So to me, you're speaking truth, you know, and I really appreciate that. And I love the movement that you guys have created. So thank you so much. And
thank you
for this amazing show. And we'll see you next time you come around.
Thanks for having us, man.
Gracias.
Black and brown power, you heard? Salud, yes. Libertad.
Hey, what's up? We're here with Emma from Dead Prez. Hi, Emma. How are you?
I'm good.
Sorry.
No, it's all good. I'm fantastic. Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you, too.
Yeah, all power to the people.
I wanted to ask you a question about your activism. I know that you were recently in Cairo, and with everything that's going on in the Middle East, I find it really interesting that you were over there and that you are constantly doing work. And I want to see how you can translate some of the actions that have been happening over there into the United States and if you can see some change here.
Wow. Well, I mean great question. I guess this is tenfold. We could go. I was privileged enough to go and be a part of a convoy that was headed to Palestine through Cairo called Viva Palestina, hooked up with an organization called Existence is Resistance. This was in 2009. It was my first trip over to the so-called Middle East. I was able to participate in solidarity with, our movement, showing, you know, like the anti-imperialist struggle united with that of the Palestinian people. That was the goal and the aim of what that was. I think we were successful. I was only able to be in Palestine for 24 hours due to bureaucracy and a whole bunch of other kind of like, you know, exercises that were like the really Israeli controlled through the Egyptian government. I was able to definitely see the basis of why Egypt erupted into what it is because of, it's kind of like firm imperialist stance. But I can say, I learned a lot from that experience. If you want to find out more, because it's an amazing experience, you can look at it at deadprez.com. Go to deadprez.com and you can see some a blog or that I had written around it. There's about 5,000 words is there, and it talks about a little bit more of it. But the idea is solidarity, to show that imperialism is not right in America and it's not right in Palestine. It's the same imperialism. It's not right in Africa. That's not right in L.A. It's not right in South America. That's not right in the world. So it's the same imperialism. So that's what it's about.
So basically, know your enemy, like you said before, right? Which is
definitely
ignorance, right?
Know your enemy, know yourself. That's my politic. Know yourself. Know who you are. Know what we're aiming at. I think we got to start aiming at globalism. We got to start communicating by using every weapon we can: the camera, the microphone, the fashion, the culture, and So.
Well, thank you so much for your time, and you had an amazing show. And I hope that you enjoy the rest of your stay here in the Bay Area. Muchas gracias. Me despido. Me llamo Jazmin Morelos para Babylon Strain. Chao.